Hi, I'm Dana Murchison, and I'm a staff scientist here in the Body Zone at Science Norm. About DNA, and we're going to talk about mutations and what it means to be a mutant. So, as I said, I'm a staff scientist, but believe it or not, I am also a mutant. And so are you, and so is every single person that you know. So we're going to talk about what that means. If you've seen cartoons, you probably know that being a mutant has something to do with your DNA. But what is DNA? DNA is the language of life. It's easily the most fascinating substance on the face of the planet. It is the thing that is found inside all of your cells that teaches your body how to be the unique person that you are. So unless you have an identical twin, nobody on the whole face of the planet has the same DNA as you. So your DNA makes you unique, but it also has some of the same DNA as your parents and your sisters and brothers, so it connects you to the people in your family. And finally, it connects you to every living thing that has ever existed on the face of the planet. It's a really amazing molecule. You've probably heard of DNA being a double helix. It's this twisted molecule that's tiny, tiny, tiny. It's microscopic. You see it in all of your cells. So it looks a little bit like this. What we're going to do is we're going to talk a little bit more about the structure of DNA, and then you'll understand what it means to have a mutation in it. So this is kind of a close-up of the DNA model that we have here. It's just been untwisted. And what you can see is that it's made up of a number of different chemicals. Here we've got them represented in different colors of plastic. So you have the two sides of your DNA ladder that are made up of a pattern of purple and red pieces. And you have the rungs of the ladder that are made up by pairs that are either orange and blue or green and yellow. So we'll talk about the different pieces. Along the sides, you have a pattern of purple, which represents a phosphate molecule, and the red, which represents a sugar molecule. This is a special kind of sugar that puts the D in DNA. It's called deoxyribose sugar, and that's what makes DNA deoxyribonucleic acid. So the sides of the ladder, the sides of your DNA molecule, sugar, phosphate, sugar, phosphate, sugar, phosphate. Then in the middle, you have these pairs. You've probably heard of A, C, T, and G being the different bases inside your DNA. So that is what these represent. You have orange and blue together. These are A for adenine, T for thymine, and green and yellow. These are C for cytosine and G for guanine. So what you see when you look at a piece of DNA is that it really does look like a ladder. Within that ladder, you always have this pattern of bases that are connected together. Always orange with blue and always green with yellow. A bonds to T, C bonds to G. So when you have a mutation, that's when one of these A, C, T, and G is in the wrong place inside your DNA. And one example of that is in the gene for hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a protein that's found in your blood, and it carries oxygen around your body. And one tiny, tiny, tiny change in it can have absolutely devastating health effects. So we decided we were going to build the gene for hemoglobin, but unfortunately it didn't fit on this spiral right here. So we had to find a slightly bigger spiral here at Science North. So let's go take a look at it. So as I mentioned before, this is the gene for hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a protein that carries oxygen in your blood. It's one of the most commonly made proteins in your body. It packs your red blood cells. So your red blood cells are just little packages full of hemoglobin. So the hemoglobin gene is very important. It's about 580 base pairs long. And if you have one tiny little mutation in it, at this point, right here, it causes a different shaped hemoglobin protein. That differently shaped hemoglobin protein is going to pack your red blood cells and cause red blood cells that are differently shaped than they should be. Those differently shaped red blood cells can't properly make it through your capillaries, and it can cause these really painful episodes of restricted blood flow, and it'll shorten your lifespan. So most people with sickle cell anemia only live between 42 and 48 years. So right here, in the normal hemoglobin gene, there's an A at this position. If that's mutated to a T at that position, that one tiny little change will cause that differently shaped hemoglobin protein that I just told you about. And if you inherit two copies of this defective gene, you will have the disease sickle cell anemia. So as I said, it's not something that would necessarily be mutated spontaneously in your body, but it is a mutation that you would inherit from your parents.